Hello, it's Jim from JetsonHacks.com. On today's show, we are going to use Jetpack 4.1 to install the system software and libraries on board the NVIDIA Jetson AGX Xavier Developer Kit. If that doesn't make you want to stick around, I don't know what would. Let's get started. Let's go over the hardware setup. You will need a PC, either a desktop or a laptop, running Ubuntu 16.04 or Ubuntu 18.04. For the purposes of this demonstration, we have a laptop running Ubuntu 16.04. The laptop is hooked into a gigabit Ethernet switch. You will also need your Xavier, of course. The Xavier is hooked into the Ethernet switch. The Ethernet switch is hooked into the internet. The Xavier is hooked into this HDMI monitor and also into a USB hub, which connects the keyboard and the mouse. You will also need the USB-A to USB-C cable that was provided with the developer kit. Plug the USB-C into the Xavier on the front panel. The front panel is where the GPIO pins are. And plug the USB-A side into the PC. Now let's switch over to the PC and install the software. We go to the Jetpack webpage. I've already signed into the developer portal. Let's download Jetpack 4.1 Developer Preview EA. That takes us to the Jetson Download Center. Let's open this up. Okay, we go over here to the downloads area. Let's take a look at it. Show in the folder. I have made up a folder to store it in. We will copy it over there. Let's take a look at the install guide. And here are the instructions that you are supposed to follow. Let's change the Jetpack install permissions so that we can execute it as a program. Then we'll switch over to this directory. Now we're ready to run Jetpack. Jetpack SDK is the most comprehensive solution for building AI applications. Okay, next. This looks good. Let's enable usage collection. Next. This looks good. Next. Now we're in the Components Manager, and this will allow us to install different packages. This is on the host side, which is the PC, and the target is the Jetson AGX Xavier. This looks good. Let's compile the CUDA samples also. Next. Please read the license agreements. Oh my. I'll just accept it. My fate is sealed. Passwords. Depending on the component selection, please pay attention to the prompt in Embedded Terminal.
Okay.
Host installation complete. Now we're ready to start the target hardware setup. Next. Please select the network layout. This looks like ours. Next. Next, we select the network interface. That looks like us. Next. The following actions will be performed. That's a lot of stuff. Next. Please put your device to force USB recovery mode. Okay, it's time to put the Xavier into force recovery mode. There are three buttons on the side of the Xavier. The middle button is the force recovery button. Hold that down. Then press the power button. And then release them both. There are three buttons on the side of the Xavier. This is the reset button, force recovery, and this is the power button. In order to put the Xavier into force recovery mode, with the Xavier powered off, press the force recovery button, the middle button, and then press the power on button. Then release both. The power light indicator should come on. At this point, you should be able to see the Xavier over USB. So let's check to make sure that we're in recovery mode. We'll look on the host, open up a new terminal. We sing the magic song. LSUSB. And there it is. We can close this up. And then we hit enter. That's a good sign, the Xavier starting to boot. And there we have the desktop. That's a good sign. Jetpack then installs the packages and SDKs that we requested. Installation complete. Okay, close this window up. Okay, our Xavier is set up and ready to go. Of course, the next time that we run Jetpack, it won't have to download all the packages, so it will flash much more quickly. You also don't have to have the samples compiled and all that. Let's run a few demos and see how it looks. Okay, we're over here on the Xavier. I've set it up to do some demos. The first thing that we want to do is set the MVP model. This defines the performance characteristics. Let's take a look and see what mode we are in currently. It says that we are in mode 15 watt. Mode 15 watt emulates the energy envelope of a Jetson TX2. Let's switch that over to maximum performance. Okay, let's close this up. For the first demo, let's take a look at some of the OpenGL examples. This is the Ocean FFT. And let's look at the smoke particles. As we expect, we get snappy performance. Let's look at some other demos. Let's take a look at a couple of the VisionWorks demos. We'll need a terminal. Let's take a look at the feature tracker. You can see that the program has identified some features and is tracking their motion flow. Let's put that aside for the moment. Let's take a look at an object tracker. We'll need another terminal. You can see we're tracking this truck here. Let's close these demos up. And then our last demo is one of the Tegra multimedia API samples. This one's called Backend. The demonstration will use GoogleNet to track objects. The instructions for running this demo are in the NVIDIA Tegra Linux multimedia API reference manual. It takes a while to build up for the first run. Once we have the cached model, it loads a lot faster, of course. Here we're tracking the little cars. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.